gonna make finding the sum of some summation formulas a lot easier. The great news is you don't have to memorize these, you just have to know how to use them, because you can write these on your formula sheet as well, right? Let me find them, because I don't have to memorize either. The super great news is I think you only have like 5 problems on your homework or something ridiculous, and they're not proofs. So how about this? If you wanted to add up the sum of the first n integers, so let's say you wanted to add up 1 to 100, you could head on your calculator and add them up. Or there's a formula that says if n is the last number that you're adding up to, the formula is n times n plus 1 divided by 2. So on your test, if I ask you to add up the numbers from 1 to 50, I don't really mean that you sit there and add them up on your calculator. I mean that you use this formula. Is it wrong if you use your calculator? No, but it takes you a lot more time, and you only have 48 minutes, right? So you want to use this formula. And there's actually a formula for adding up numbers that are squared and cubed and to the fourth power and to the fifth power. So that's what we're going to do on these. There's a formula if you add up the first n integers squared. So if you want to add up 1 to 100 all squared, instead of adding them up, you can just use a formula. So the first one is really nice, and then they get a little crazier from there. This one is n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 all divided by 6. I'm super impressed at who, discovered these. The cool thing is we could do proof by induction to prove all of these. We're not going to, but we could. The top one would be the easiest, and then they get crazier from there. But we could do proof by induction. The next one is cube numbers if you add them up. People like to see if there's a pattern going on here, and it kind of just gets, the n and the n plus 1 kind of stay constant, but other than that, there's really no pattern here. So if I'm adding cube numbers up, it's going to be n squared times n plus 1 squared all divided by 4. It goes back to a smaller number than 6. I don't know. Fourth power. And we're going to the fifth power. Then I don't know if there's a rule after that or we just don't care. Where it gets a little out of control. N times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1, which is the same as a squared, times 3n squared plus 3n minus 1, all divided by 30.
Good thing I don't make you memorize that.
And the last one I don't think is as bad as the fourth power. The fourth power one's the awful one. N squared times n plus 1 squared, which is like the third, times 2n squared plus 2n minus 1, all divided by 12. And the idea is, even though some of these are crazy formulas, still faster than adding them all up by hand or even with a calculator. Well, I just have a couple of things.
So we could do questions like this. We could definitely do this without the formula, but it says summation from 1 to 10 of n cubed. 1 to 10 isn't so bad. We could take 1 cubed plus 2 cubed plus 3 cubed plus 4 cubed all the way to n cubed on a calculator. But if I said do that from 1 to 50, that would take you a long time, especially during a test that you're trying to get a bunch of other problems done. So the idea here is when you see n cubed, you think, oh, I have that formula that I just wrote out for the cube, sum of cube numbers, and the formula says n squared times n plus 1 squared divided by 4. And I got that because I'm using the cubed formula. And what do you think n is in this problem? Yeah, it's just where we're stopping. So we're stopping at the 10th number, so n is 10. We're stopping at the 476th number, then we plug in 476, whatever that top number is. So that's just going to be 10 squared times 10 plus 1, which is 11 squared, divided by 4. And that's still faster than adding those up, even just 1 to 10. Yes? I think should be 3025 if you want to check for birthday. I do want to point out, I really only have one other example, but in the book, people were having issues with this because they wrote something like this. Like 1 to the 4 plus 2 to the 4 plus 3 to the 4 plus ... 55 to the 4th. And they said, how do I know what to do? Which formula do you think you would use on that one if they're 1 to the 4th, 2 to the 4th, 3 to the 4th? The 4th power one, and what would n be in this problem? Because that's your last number. Does that make sense? So instead of writing it as a summation, sometimes they write it as a pattern. So like on this one, we would do the 4th one, which is, oh, why would I do 4? That's a terrible one. I don't want to really write that all out, but 4th power where n is 55. Yes? I don't, it's not the 4th power on your homework. I was trying to change it, but I forgot 4 was awful. What else can we do with this? We can simplify and break up summations using these two. So what about something like this? Again, you could just work this out. Summation from 1 to 10. Of 3 minus 1 half j plus 1 half j squared, where you could plug in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 to all of those. But that would take a while to do, even with the calculator. So there are properties of summations, and one property of summations says that you can separate addition and subtraction. Another property says that if you have, like, a letter times a number, then you can separate that. So let me separate these and see if you see what I'm talking about here. So I could write this as j equals 1 to 10 of just 3. And then I'm going to separate that. Oh, sorry. And I'm going to pull that minus 1 half out and just say from 1 to 10 minus 1 half. And I could do the summation and then multiply by negative 1 half. And the same thing with this one. I can pull the 1 half out front. Then I have j squared. And probably once I do this once, you're not going to actually show me this on your homework because you're going to just realize, oh, I can just use the formula and then multiply by 1 half. But I just want to show you that this is actually what the property says. And forget about the 3 for a minute because that's kind of different. Do I have a formula for j squared or n squared? Do I have a formula for just the first n numbers? So when you get down to just the letters, you can go back to the formulas and you can use those, and then you just multiply by the numbers in front. But let's think about the first one for a minute. What if I want you to add up the first 10 numbers when the sequence formula is just 3? What would the first term be? What would the second term be? What would the third term be? And the fourth term would be 3, and the fifth term would be 3. So do you agree that if I wrote that out from 1 to 10, I would have 3 plus 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 3? Or how many 3s would I have? So can you think of maybe a shortcut to add up when it's just a number?
times 10. If I wrote 3 50 times, if that number was 50, I would have 3 times 50. You could just write it out if you want, but there's a shortcut to that too. You just take the constant times that number, and it's just 3 over and over again. Minus 1 half, and then if I do the formula for just the first n terms, even though it's j, I'm just going to write this. It would be n times n plus 1 divided by 2. I'm going to plug 10 in a minute. I just want to show you where these formulas are coming from. And the squared one would be n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 all divided by 6. On your homework, they like for you to practice with the n's. So on your homework, there's a couple problems like this. But instead of giving you 10 up here, they put n up there, which means you don't have a number to plug in. Like, you just are going to simplify this. And I used to be really mean. I know you probably think I still am. But I used to make kids, like, get a common denominator with all their n's, and I just, I don't know, I'm kind of over it. So as long as you use the formulas correctly, we'll see in a minute when you get to your homework. But on this one, because there's actually a 10 up there, we can actually get a number answered, right? Like, we can say that this is 10 times 11 divided by 2. And this is actually 10 times 11 times 21 divided by 6. And you can actually find the sum of that.
I think that's 55 halves. But if you work all that out, I simplified.
I got that to be 385 halves. And when I put that all together,
I got 195. You could just do it on your calculator.
I just did it.
Did you get 195? Again, on your homework, some of these problems, they don't have a number at the top. So, like, this would be an N also. And you just simplify as much as you can. Like, I would say you could put that together and make it 1/4 on the bottom. But you can just leave your N's up there, and I'll help you with that when you get to it if you're not sure what to do.
But that's really it for today, which means if you didn't get the rest of the homework done from yesterday, really good idea to go back and finish that up. But also, you have like 15 minutes, which means you should get this assignment done in class. So the smart thing to do would either be to start your chapter review tonight or to start your formula sheet tonight. Cool, did you have a question? So again, this is different than your assignment sheet because I changed it up on you. But 25 and 28 are like the first example that we did. And 32, 33, and 34 are like our last example, except for it has n's in it instead of 10. And that's it. And this shouldn't take you more than about 10 minutes to do. And then you either need to finish up other homework or figure out what you want to work on tonight so you don't have so much to do tomorrow before your test Friday. Try to give you as much time as I can tomorrow to work on your review in class. But you still have a lot to do. We've done a lot in this chapter.
Hold on, let me stop recording.